Hello, beautiful people. Today's video will be sponsored by Rose Forever. These are actually vegan flowers. They are handmade. They are made to last up to a year. They come in different colors. They also come in different, the boxes also come in different shapes and sizes that you can either get for yourself, you can get them for your loved one, or you can get it for your spouse, you know? And they do smell really, really good. I will have a coupon code in the description box for you all to use it. It's a $25 off discount. The discount code is Bella25. Okay, y'all. But yeah, if y'all want to get y'all some roses, you know, to make yourself, you know, feel good, you know, get you some. They smell good. So yeah, they smell good, you know. And I decided to get orange because, you know, it's kind of fallish and it's giving me, like, you know, well, for one, I got orange because I need to work on my sacral chakra. So this is gonna help me a lot, you know, looking at the color orange and, you know, like smelling. This don't really smell like orange. It's got a little flowery taste, not taste. Smell to it, y'all. But happy fall. I'm sorry that I've been gone for a good little minute, but I'm back. I'm back, y'all, and we're gonna do something a little different today. We're actually gonna do a pick a card reading. I'm gonna keep this in the frame, okay? I'm gonna keep this in the frame, and then another thing that I'm gonna do as well. I'm gonna let y'all see the cards this time instead of looking at my face, okay? Well, I don't necessarily say like instead of looking at my face, but I know I've been gone for a long time, so this is just something new that I'm trying out. Y'all can tell me how y'all like it or how y'all not gonna like it. Just work with me while I figure this out. But yeah, all right, then I see y'all and y'all pick a chord. Okay, so shit now. All right, you need to go on and bend now. This thing don't want to bend. So I guess that's mainly like what y'all gonna see. I'm trying to keep this in the frame. Maybe I should do them like this. Yeah, y'all can see them. Y'all can see the roses. But make sure y'all go get y'all roses. Y'all can get y'all some roses for yourself, for your partner, you know, a loved one, or for your kids, whoever. You know, just spread the love, you know, and don't forget to use my code. Okay, so the crystals that we have, the first pile, I'm going to use all the decks for each pile. But y'all look at me. I just got shit everywhere. But yeah, y'all, I'm gonna use the piles for all the decks. I'm gonna not use the piles. I'm gonna use all the decks for all the piles. But tonight we're gonna do something a little different. Okay. Let me move this over, honey. I guess. Let's scoot back here. Y'all see these roses? Okay. Okay, y'all. So I'm gonna use all the decks, but y'all know tonight is Womb Wednesday. I will post. No, I won't. Don't get me lying, y'all. I gotta stay on track. But yeah. So these are your options. I will use all the decks. So the questions that's gonna be answered depending on which pile you choose, it's just gonna be whatever messages that you need. This is gonna be a Womb Wednesday. So this is how we're gonna do the Womb Wednesday instead of doing like each sign or whatever, or just do one reading since I've been gone for so long. I do apologize, you know. I'm a human, I'm going through life changes, that's just it, okay? I gotta preserve my energy and I still gotta take care of my household at the same time, okay? So thank you for coming back. But these are gonna be your Womb Wednesday messages, and whatever comes out, that's what comes out, and that's what you need to know, okay? So right here we have the specularite. Hope I'm saying it right. This right here is just a regular quartz, clear quartz. Okay. And then we have the amethyst. Okay. So whichever crystal you're drawn to, or whichever deck you're drawn to, just choose your pile. Okay. I'll get this editing stuff down packed, but until then, and y'all gonna get all these bloopers. Okay. Alright, y'all. Okay, maybe you need to scoot over here a little bit. Yes, I need my own space. Y'all can see it in the corner, right? Alright. And I did, I was called to play some music. Okay, so like, hopefully. Child. I need to stop saying it. They did play like a couple of my videos, but. We gotta get these messages out, y'all. And I did have some, channel messages that I wrote down while I was working. Bitch, gotta find them. Is this it? But how y'all been, though? Y'all ready for Halloween? If y'all, well, I'm pretty sure y'all celebrate Halloween. Y'all watching me. But then again, some people probably don't. So let me not say that. But they probably do. Who knows? Child, look at all these damn pages. This is what I get for just writing all over the place. I just open up the book and start writing, y'all. I don't even... Whatever. This is none of y'all business. All right, let's go. All right. So your angel's number is 117, 808. You've probably been seeing 111, 444, 333, 1166, 9988, and 55. Okay. Those are your angel numbers. Okay. Another message that I got for you all as well is, they want you, your ancestors want you to be more curious. They want you to be more aware. They want you to start being honest with yourself and others. They want you to be more open without, you know, exposing too much. Okay. They also want you to start being proactive. They want you to start being present. Like, they want you to start showing up for yourself. They also want you to, I feel like a lot of stuff is going to get revealed to you, and they just want you to like pay attention to people, like body languages, like pay attention to the way that they communicate with you, to pay attention to how they like treat you, pay attention to their tone, pay attention to the discussions. I'm also hearing like, just read between the lines. Or maybe I feel like you may be dealing with somebody that wants you to read between the lines. But I feel like you're going to end up getting the type of clarity that you need. And, yeah, I feel like it's going to be a win-win situation regardless. Because, you know, everything is going to be, like, settled or whatever. They're telling you to be more flexible. Get on board, like be open to collaborations like this right here, like, you know, like they sent me this or whatever. So they're telling you to be more open to collaboration. So like, maybe if you like a content creator, or if you have like a business or whatever, like, you know, like just be open to collabing with other people, you know, so you could be around like-minded people. But I also feel like too, that's like another sign that like-minded people are coming into your life, and like-minded people are going to start reaching out to you. Okay. So like, just be prepared for that. Okay. So they're telling you to go ahead and get ready, to be ready, so you don't have to get ready. Okay. They're telling you to be mindful of like what you say. They also want you to be mindful of your thoughts, because we all know that we manifest with our thoughts. I'm also hearing something about like express or whatever, so you may be adding like express delivery to to your online website or whatever, or maybe they telling you to go ahead and add that before Black Friday. They telling you to stop blocking your ascension by being resistant, okay? And then there was like another message that I got was like a smooth operator. So they was like, be careful of like smooth operators. And another message that I got too was like, was speaking in tongues. Now I know that you have to be blessed like with that gift or whatever, but this is like the message for the collective before we even start to pick a card, okay? They telling you to like learn how to talk to God, or learn, or build a relationship up with God to where you can understand him in multiple ways, to where you can communicate with him in multiple ways, okay? I feel like that's just like the best way to put it. I mean, we all on this channel, we all on this spiritual journey. So with all of us being on this channel and with all of us being on this spiritual journey, we know that this is not a physical war, it's a spiritual war, okay? And we also know too that everybody is not open about whatever they practice, okay? And yeah, everybody is not open about what they practice. So it's like a complete it could be somebody that you know that could be like attacking you like spiritually, or like trying to tap into your dream state, or you know, they may be like hacking into your computer or hacking into your accounts, or they probably got your phone tapped or something like that. They just telling you to learn a different way to communicate with God, because you know, like if they tapping into your dream state, then they could be tapping into your conscious mind to where, or just tap into your energy period to where they can see everything that you got going on, and they can hear all of your prayers and all of your talks with God. Then you also have people as well that's out here manipulating energy. So it's like you could be thinking that like it's one person, what they call them, familiar spirits. You could be thinking that like it's one person communicating with you. Like this is how high the spiritual warfare is. Like you could be thinking that it's one person like communicating with you and trying to get your attention, when it's really just somebody that's like using a demon or using one of their ancestors or whatever they play with to come after you, to you know, and just be in a disguise to make you feel comfortable with like still sitting right there, like either you praying or you sleep or something like that, or to where like you'll be telling them everything that's going on. Or you also have it too, like where people can like it's like I said, the damn familiar spirit, like they'll actually send like a spirit to you to where you'll actually see like the body or whatever, or they gonna either send like a spirit to where it'll be like a human or whatever, or they'll send a spirit to where like it'll be like a telepathy. Now some people do know how to speak through telepathy, okay? Some people do and some people don't. But yeah, like some people like will like tap in to your conscious and make you think that like, you know, you having a whole conversation with somebody that you think you're having a conversation with and you're not. But that's why it's very important for you to take your path seriously. And that's why it's very important for you to have that connection with God. And that's why it's also very important for you to have a deep connection and a deep bond with whoever you do communicate with through telepathy, so that you'll know like, okay, somebody sent this spirit. Like you'll know the difference. Like, okay, like either somebody, it's gonna either be somebody sent you that spirit, or it's really gonna be that person. But it's like, if you don't take your path seriously, then you're not gonna know, and you're gonna be sitting around looking crazy because you're allowing the spiritual warfare to take over, when it's like it's not even real, it's just an illusion, okay? Or like I said, it's not even that person, it's just somebody like trying to disguise as that person or whatever. So they're just telling you to be careful with that. I'm also hearing too, like, why we got the roses right here, like this would be the perfect time to take a self-love bath, okay, so that you can bring that love and pour that love back into yourself, so you can call that back into yourself. Because I feel like a lot of y'all probably been feeling like y'all been overextending yourself, or maybe a lot of y'all probably been overworking to the point to where like you just getting sick out of nowhere, or your energy like just been depleted out of nowhere, or just anything. They also telling you to like pay attention, like with this body language, like pay attention to how pay attention to other people's body language, but also pay attention to your own body language. Like whenever you talking to somebody, or like whenever you around somebody, like they really want you to connect with yourself and to connect with source, so you can learn yourself and so that you can learn source, so you can know those voices. You know what I'm saying? And then also too, another thing that I'm getting as well, like y'all know people be having astral sex or whatever, but you got to be careful with that as well, because like, oh, I'm hearing too, okay, before this leave my mind, I'm also hearing too, like y'all need to be careful of like the type of people that y'all decide to entertain, and the type of people that y'all decide to deal with. Because like some people, like if you make them mad enough, like everybody has their own levels of being upset or getting upset or being mad, whatever the case may be. But like if you make them mad enough, like people really, excuse me y'all, should I say that? Should they like go in? All right, but people really be out here like they can do magic on your sex life as well. And people I'm not even gonna get too deep with that, but they can do magic on your sex life as well. Like if you've been wondering like for the men, like a evil woman like will or can like do magic to where like your shit won't get up with somebody else. Now sometimes, like, you know, you probably really not attracted to that person, and you probably really want to be with that other person, so it's not getting up. Or it could be like, you know what I'm saying, like she did some little work so you wouldn't get up. Like if you've been wondering like why you can't get up, or like for our female, this is gonna get a little explicit, like this is like 18+, but like even for like the females, like believe it or not, like men do more magic. Like men do, I ain't gonna say more magic, but men do magic just as much as women do magic. It's as many it's a lot of witches out here, and the same amount of witches that are out here are the same amount of warlocks out here, okay? So just be like really, really careful about like who you're dealing with. But just like how a woman can put a spell on a man so his thing won't get up, a man or a woman would do it. You know, it's evil bitches out here. Would do a spell to where like, you know, you can't nut, or like if you a squirter, like you won't be able to squirt. Like, I don't know. I did a couple of readings and I don't know. But yeah, like that's why it's just like it's like very important for you to like to get in tune. And then too as well, like you gotta be careful too, like if you into like astral sex or whatever. Like they just telling me you gotta be careful, like if you into that shit too, because people will send you sex demons that are just there to deplete your energy, or will just like come around like just to get information out of you, okay? And this is my sign, like they like you hit it like right on the nail in the coffin, or however you say that. They also What was I about to say about, I think I said all that. But yeah, they all, yeah, another thing too, like, they also want you to be, like, cautious of, like, the type of company that you keep. They also want you to be, like, be cautious of the type of company that you keep, because everybody that's rooting for you really not rooting for you. I know that sounds like so stereotypical, but yeah, they not the fake congratulations, you look good, like this look. Now some people do be genuine, but yeah, it's that I feel like you just gonna see a lot. I'm hearing like in the next like 8 days, you gonna see a lot. You gonna see too, like, where a lot of people like being like manipulative. And I feel like this go round. I feel like this go round, like, maybe in the past, like, it probably would have been like hard for you to like to handle situations, but I feel like you not graduated up to a point to where it's like the stuff don't phase you the same way it phased you in the past. So you just like, well, whatever, because it's like you get into that point to where you are learning and growing to trust your intuition more. So it's like your intuition already told you this was gonna happen either months or years ago. So it's like, if it was already shown to you, why are you reacting and not responding? Or why are you even responding at all if you already, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, I just hear growth. Like, I hear spiritual growth. I hear physical growth. I hear mental growth, emotional growth. Like, I'm seeing, like, in my head right now, I'm seeing, like, the King of Cups. So, I feel like you probably was, like, going through, like, a lot of situations that was triggering you, you know? And maybe, like, the old you would have reacted, you know, but it's like the new you, it's just like, all right, bitch, like, try a new trick, you know what I'm saying? Or it's just like, all right, bitch, like you got some type of mental illness, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't get it. But it's like, that's what card came out, perception. I feel like you're gonna get to the point to where you gonna handle situations a lot better because you now learn how to change your perception. You're no longer looking at stuff on a 3D level. You're looking at everything and everybody from a spiritual standpoint. So it's like, by you looking at everybody and everything from a spiritual standpoint, it makes it easier for you to forgive. It makes it easier for you to let go. You know what I'm saying? And it makes it easier for you to just walk away. That's the same thing as let go, but it just make it easier. Like you know, like how you, I feel like you're gonna get to a point, like how old people be. Like, you know, like how a young person, like, they not gonna, well, I ain't gonna say a young person, but yeah, a younger person, they just gonna be like ready, like they gonna be on go if somebody like cross them or cuss them out, right, in the grocery store, right? But you go inside the grocery store and you see the older people, right? And the older people, like, y'all ain't never noticed. Now, some old people do be with the sheets, but like, y'all ain't never noticed that, like, when people be being rude to, like, old people, they just look at them. And I never really understood why they did that until a few years back. But I was like, why they don't, like, speak up for themselves? Like, why they just stand there? And it's like, they stand there because they not grew and they not learned, right? They not grew and they not learned. And they didn't learn how to change their perspective. their perspective on a situation, right? So you probably thinking that, oh, like, you get into this old lady or you hurting this old lady feelings, not knowing that this old lady is looking at you like, this person is hurt, this person is wounded, you know what I'm saying? Like, whatever they going through, it don't got shit to do with me. You know what I'm saying? And another thing too, is like you got to a point to where it's like you understand how life works. Like, you understand how karma works. And I feel like that's how it is, like, with older people. It's like you got to be careful about, like, what you say and, like, what you put out there. Now, if you call to put something out there, if God put something on your spirit or your heart to put something out there, then it's gonna get out there. Or hell, even when it come down to these readings, like, if anything that you say triggers your viewers in a negative way, you did your job. So it's just like, stop being so hard on yourself, because their problem is not your problem, or whatever issue that they have with you is not your problem. It's personal, okay? It's a deep wound that they not ready to get rid of. I feel like I just shifted. I'm getting so many messages right now, but they telling you to, like, to just change your perception. I feel like either you already in this energy, or you're gonna be walking into this energy, because you're gonna start to see, like, okay, like you intentionally, like, tried to be manipulative. Like, you was intentionally trying to seek revenge. You was intentionally trying to make this situation go this way, or whatever the case may be. Like, yeah, I feel like you just gonna eventually just get to a point to where you just, like, whatever. Like, I understand that this person need help. I understand that they need healing. God, do whatever you need to do for them, or provide whatever you need to provide for them. And you just gonna leave it at that. You know, it's just gonna roll on off your shoulder. I feel like you're gonna get to that point. I also feel like too, you're gonna start to see, like, the beauty that's, like, within you, like, and you're also gonna start to see your self-worth and your value as well. It's like I'm getting, like, your value went up. So it's like the fact that your value went up. This is a long reading. I hope I got enough memory to do this whole pick a card. But yeah, and I'm hearing, like, your value, it went up. So you need to start acting like it. Like, not saying you got to go out here and act like a bitch or be a bitch, but they telling you, like, what is, like, you're a total badass, right? Like, you are. So you need to start acting like, you need to start walking like it. Then on the back, you got renewal, and you have regeneration, awakening, and fortune. Okay, so that's what I was saying. Like, in the next 8 days, they're probably, like, what y'all been dealing with. I know I've been gone for a month, so y'all probably already went through this energy. But I just feel like you're just going through, like, a whole rebirth. And I feel like a lot of people, like, they not gonna recognize you, they not gonna notice you, or a lot of people gonna be approaching you and be expecting you to, this is deep. The heart knows what the eyes can't see. So it's like, you know that these people need healing, you know these people need help, or you know these people got some type of mental issues. So it's just like, you just gonna be like, you know what? My heart goes out to you. I'm going to pray for you. I forgive you. Be blessed. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like with this renewal, okay, I feel like you're going to get to a point to where you're going to be like, okay, the old me, the nigga inside of me want to say, like, suck my dick. I'm sorry. Excuse my language. But I feel, you know, like, how when you get mad, you be like, you know how niggas. exist. I feel like the old you used to be like, okay, the nigga in me is like, suck my dick, okay? And then it's like the bitch in you is like, kiss my ass. But the new you is like, baby, be blessed. The new you is like, okay, I totally understand. Be blessed. You're going to get to that point, all right? Yeah, because it's like you're completing these cycles. You walking into your fulfillment. You got a rainbow right here. And I feel like eventually you're going to get to the point to where you're just going to be like, be blessed, because you realize and you've awakened yourself to, I am the essential piece, okay? So if I'm the essential piece, then that means that I am valuable. That means that I am worthy. That means that I am needed, not just wanted. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like, not trying to say like, oh, you want to get to a point to where like, oh, like, these people need me. But I feel like this is coming out because I feel like spirit or your ancestors want you to acknowledge the fact that, like, you know, you... I'm not going to necessarily say, like, you are a big deal, but you do make a huge difference in the world. You do make a huge difference in other people's lives. You do allow others to see the bigger picture. You do help other people get out of whatever situation that they need to get out of. You know what I'm saying? Like, even though it's not the traditional rainbow, we all know that the traditional rainbow are the colors of the chakras, okay? So it's like, yeah, like, you are an essential piece because you were called here to balance things out, whether you the tower or whether you the rainbow in their life. Either way, you are sent here to do a job, and they want you to be obedient, and they want you to act accordingly, okay? All right, y'all. So let's get to the pick a card after 30 minutes. what was the crystal? It was speculum, right? Okay. So if you chose this crystal, this message is for you. I'm going to get the index cards as well. I said I need to make some more because, you know. I think I am. All right, y'all. So we're going to try to use all the deck. Try to keep them short. Like I said, I don't even know how much memory I got. All right, y'all. So let's see what your index card is going to be. The tricky knife already came out. Being resistant, these cards don't want to shuffle. Okay, so right off the bat, they want y'all to stop being resistant. Okay, you got trust, which makes sense. They want you to trust the process. Wishy washy, God bless. Okay, so this takes oxygen to the brain, digestion, and increase the mother's milk. Okay, so you probably just had a child and you may be having a problem with breastfeeding. So this herb right here would be really good for you to take to help you to breastfeed, okay? I also feel like too, like with the takes oxygen to the brain, they telling me to tell you to get you like a plant. Like I'm saying, like a greenhouse, or maybe you have like a greenhouse, or maybe you have like a sunroom or something, and it's filled with plants. Okay, you got save yourself, you got dresser, you got upgrade. All right, y'all can't see it, but you got upgrade, and then you got candles, and then you got trust your path, then you got thong, and then you got mind control. Okay, so it's like, what I'm getting from this, right? I feel like right off the bat, somebody is doing, I was just talking about this, y'all. Look, you gotta save yourself. You got candles, you got mind control, and then you got thong, okay? I feel like somebody, remember I said something about that? Y'all see this? I feel like somebody probably, yeah, I feel like somebody is doing like sending y'all the sex demons, okay? Or I feel like somebody trying to use magic, like just to have sex with you. Yeah, like they probably gonna tell you to like come spend a night, or they probably gonna be like, let's go get a room or something somewhere. Like they probably gonna try to like take you out, get you drunk. And yeah, this makes sense. Somebody gonna try to get you. Somebody is manifesting. Okay, so I got two different things. Okay, I got somebody gonna try to. Somebody is manifesting you just so they can have sex with you. Okay, so beware of that. I also feel like too. This is for the second person. The first person not gonna stay. They just want to have sex, and this is why I said people use magic for dumb. Well, I feel like it's stupid, but it may be smart to them. But I feel like you gonna attach yourself for one night stand. Like, why not do it for somebody that you want to spend the rest of your life with? You know what I'm saying? That you gonna marry, you know, or be long time with. Whatever. To each his own. No judgment zone. But hey, but yeah, I feel like with this right here, I feel like somebody else is like doing magic. It's cute though. You know, it's cute. Now, this, the wishy-washy person, they just want to one night stand. But this person right here, I feel like this person is doing magic to manifest you, because they want you to have their kids. Like this was talking about the mother's milk, right? And then this right here with the dresser, I also feel like they want y'all to move in together. And I also feel like too, like this would be like some good juju with the of course it's good juju, they want to marry you, with the upgrade card, okay? That's why they're telling you to like to trust your path. Like, I'm not saying like just openly like accept people that you know that's pulling on your energy. But I just feel like this person right here, they're being genuine because they actually want to be with you. They want to marry you. They want a family. They want the whole upgrade, the empire, like all that shit. And this motherfucker right here, they just want your thong, 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 thong. All right. Oh, I feel like they probably like buy you like some lingerie, or maybe like you probably been shopping for some lingerie. I don't know. But that was your index card. All right, let's see what the girls got to say. Maybe I shouldn't use all the same. I don't know. I'ma just whatever I'm called to pull, honey. That's what I'ma pull, honey. I ain't even gonna make this hard. We just gonna let spirit run the show like I always do. My messages come out better. Girl, you need to shuffle these cards. What's wrong with you? All right. You are in alignment. All right, what else you got for number one? This actually came out like that. So we doing the cards like this, so we not reading. Not reversals, I guess, tonight. Well, there go your double confirmation. Okay. So you are in alignment to receive your blessing. So whatever you're trying to manifest, it is going to manifest. Okay. So I feel like this is also coming out too, because look what's on top. Motherfuckers doing magic. Look at all them damn candles. Okay. All right, y'all. So this was, so the bottom one is the number, is the first person. The top one is the second person. Okay. So I feel like for the second person, you got a double confirmation. You got the level up card. You got the level up card right here, okay? So I feel like with that level up and that upgrade card, I feel like the person that's trying to manifest you, that really want to have a baby by you, that want to have the family and stuff, I feel like it's going to manifest. I feel like y'all are going to end up together and you're not going to be disappointed because, you know, this somebody that you want to be with, okay? Now, this second person, honey, look at this. That's chaos magic, okay? Chaos magic, honey. The pictures are self-explanatory, right? Even though all y'all, she comes in to bring change, but it's just like, just look at the thundering, the lightning, everything just flying around her. Like, this is just chaos. Like, it's just drama feel, like it's nothing. And I feel like this person has help, like with the magic, or you know, maybe they like in a group or something, like we're all them doing magic together, okay? Then you got the live out loud card. Yeah, this person ain't shit. This the type of person, like, you see, if you living out loud, this giving me like the club vibes. Like, this person probably go out at least like 3 or 4 times a week, okay? And they probably meet a bitch every time, which, I mean, you single, but they probably meet a female every time and get their number. And you know, if they start falling for them, or if they feel like they want to have sex with them, they go in their little back room or go with their little friends, go kiki haha, and they all go do magic together. And they have these people around them, like, doing whatever they want them to do. Giving much mind control. I feel like whoever this person is, they got like a free spirit. So this may be the type of person that like don't mind having threesomes or I don't even want to tap into that. Especially not with what I just got in her. I'm not about to repeat that shit. That's, yeah, to each his own. Do whatever you want to do in the bedroom, but I'm not about to repeat that. I'm hearing like, yeah, like the second person, like if the second person is resonating with you, like I'm hearing like just stay away from that person, because I'm hearing like this person, like the, like they like going to orgies. Yeah, they like orgies. All right. So you have home, family, ancestors, foundation. I don't feel like I need to pick no more cards because it's there, okay? Yeah, you shedding light on everything. Yeah, they telling you to not be a victim. Don't be a victim of the situation, okay? They telling you that they're shedding light on everything to help you make a decision, which is so obvious on what decision you need to make, okay? Yeah, you got pleasure and creativity, fun and hobbies. Like, whoever that second person is, like, they do that shit for a hobby. They do spell work for a hobby. Like, just stay away from them. The new person gonna be good, though. They want the home. They want the family. They are spiritually aligned. Y'all gonna have a solid foundation. They're gonna be emotionally mature. And both of y'all are gonna be able to, like, depend on each other and heal each other. Like, it's giving, like, power couple type energy. All right, you got your hard work has paid off. Okay. So you may be dealing with a Virgo, a Leo, a Pisces, or a Cancer. All right. I feel like that's it. I feel like it's going to be bittersweet to walk away from that person, but that person is not in alignment with what you're supposed to do here on earth, okay? And they just not in alignment. Well, I don't know if you okay. If you okay with your person, you know, having threesomes and going to orgies, you know, stuff like that. Like, I'm hearing, like they said, 5 people at one time. Shit like that. If you into that, you know, go ahead. But if you not, bitch, walk away. Walk away while you can. All right. So we have pile number 2. Do, 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 do. Pile number 2. All right. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry, pile number 2. We got to give, what you call it, some mudra cards. Pile number 1. All right. Alrighty. So, what do you want number 1 to say? Or what do you have to tell number 1? Girl. That's why. Child. This is my problem. Like 2 different ways, they not even. I barely shuffle these cards. This is ridiculous. Look at all these cards. Y'all energy is heavy. Maybe he don't want y'all to know that he doing magic. He might be dealing with an air sign. Transformation. And sorry, you got all these purple cards. I feel like you should work on your crown chakra and your throat chakra. All right. So your first mudra is spaciousness. You've probably been saying 555. It's going to help to assist with expansiveness, opening, and intuition. The benefits helps to release tension in the face, throat, and shoulders. Directs energy to the thyroid and parathyroid glands. Release chronic tension in the neck and shoulders, enhances intuition and hearing. The affirmation is spaciousness allows me to open to new possibilities. Okay. Your next card right here is your third eye chakra. You've probably been saying 666. This is going to help to assist with wisdom. It's located in between your brows. The color is indigo. It rules sight, senses, nervous system, pituitary gland. The qualities is intuition, wisdom, clarity, and vision. Okay? Your next card right here is transformation. You've probably been saying 888 or 999. This is going to help to assist with assimilation, vital energy, life purpose. The benefits, it helps to enhance digestion and assimilation of life experiences. Supports circulation and lymphatic systems. Cultivates energy, passion, and divine will. The affirmation is inner light illuminates and guides me on my path. Okay, so your last card right here is the air element. Remember I said you may be dealing with an air sign. This is 444. This is the yoga pose is cobra, upward dog, bridge. The senses is touch. The energy center is the heart chakra. The symbols are a gazelle, a deer, a hawk, clouds, open vistas. So I feel like y'all been doing a lot of inner child healing as well, okay? It rules the heart, the lungs, the respiratory system, thymus, nervous system. And the qualities, it helps to open up your heart, loving, light, compassionate, and forgiving. So I feel like they also telling you to, like, forgive these people as well, okay? So those are your messages, pile number 1. Pile number 2, now we can start, baby, okay? All right? So, y'all ever been hot and cold at the same time? That's how I feel right now. I got my it's like I've been awakened. Y'all know what song I'm hearing. Y'all probably should go listen to that. Halo by Beyonce. Baby, when I'm looking out, I'm surrounded by your rays. Maybe I can see your halo. Pray you won't fade away. You're everything I need and want. Let me stop. I'm about to play some music, y'all. I feel like y'all got music messages too. because it's like I'm hearing, maybe because it's late. It is late. Okay. It's late. I don't know. It's late. Hopefully you don't get flagged. All right, so whatever. Okay, so somebody's still in love with you. Somebody triggered. Sitting up here watching this damn. I'm just take all these. I flipped over. We're gonna see what's gonna come out. Y'all hear this? I just said this song right. This is the first song on this playlist. That's not Beyonce though. That's somebody else singing. Y'all, somebody is in love with y'all. I got my angel. It's like I've been awakened. Everyone's a breaking. It's the risk or that wall. I'm never gonna shut you out. Baby, when I'm looking out, I'm surrounded by your breath. Maybe I can see you alone. No, you won't see me always. You're everything I need and more. It's written all over your face. Maybe I can feel you alone. I don't even know the lyrics. That's sad. I ain't heard this song since I was in. I ain't gonna say I ain't heard it, but I ain't listened to it like that. I repeat since high school. You're the only one that I want, and I'm addicted to your light. I swear I'll never fall again, but this one didn't feel like falling. Gravity to pull me back to the ground again. Feels like I've been awakened. Every rule I had to break it. It's a risk that I'm taking. I'm never gonna shut you out. This is deep. It's 117 too, and it's 117 likes on this video, and it's 144. Okay. Alrighty. Alright, y'all. So I got a lot of messages. I feel like it's three different messages in this pile. I feel like I was supposed to grab this card, and y'all was, because look, it was right here because of what the fuck I was about to say. Alrighty, and I'll just go ahead and get this in respect. All right, y'all, this is deep. I feel like this is like somebody that passed over. This was their favorite song, I guess, or this was like one of their favorite songs, or this could be them sending you this song. So like maybe if you've been hearing this song a lot on the radio, or it's been coming on a lot on your playlist, this is the person that passed over. They trying to get your attention. Yeah, they're trying to get your attention. They want you to do your shadow work because you can't see your halo, but everybody else can, okay? And in order for you to see your halo, you have to do your shadow work, okay? That's the first message I'm getting. Next message, okay, you got this Still I Rise card, right? You got the community. You got no role models. You got old lady gang. You got clean up. You got they knew who you were before you knew. You got Aquarius. You got manipulation. Okay. You got nightlife. So something happened at night. Then you got triggered. You got gun. You got bedroom. Y'all see this, right? Y'all see me shuffling these cards. And you also got drugs. So you might be dealing with a drug dealer. It may be like a gang of females. They probably do got potential, but I feel like they probably like use their power. I'm not even gonna say it's for dumb stuff because what's dumb to you, it may not be dumb to somebody else. But I feel like they could be like a little bit more efficient in the community with their gifts or their powers or whatever they trying to do. But okay, I feel like it's a gang of females that got triggered. It's a gang of females that got triggered about something that like either you like said or like you did. Yeah, it's like they're triggered for some reason. They want y'all to know that, but they want y'all to let that go because they knew who you were before you knew who you were. That's why they was trying to stop you. That's why they was like doing like little small shit like here and there, trying to set up obstacles, trying to do spell work in the background, trying to set you up, trying to do this, trying to do that. Like you're not connected to spirit, like you don't know what's going on. And it's like you still rose above the bullshit, okay? I also feel like too, the person that passed away, they want you to go to the beach to cleanse yourself off. And they also want you to know that whatever these people got planned, like, it's gonna end up backfiring. It's like I'm also hearing too, like on the run. And I think that wasn't this CD, because this CD came out when I was in high school with this Halo song on there. So, On the Run tour. This still Beyonce. This still Beyonce. That's still her shit. All right. I feel like somebody got upset. If I can't have you, nobody can. I feel like of course it's all connected because it came out in the same reading, okay? You might be dealing with the Aquarius, okay? Or maybe you became the Aquarius, the star or whatever, after all this bullshit happened, right? All right. With this triggered and this gun and this bedroom and this drugs, I'm feeling like either this person was like on drugs or they tried to say that like this person was on drugs. Or maybe this person is like a drug dealer, a dope dealer, something like that. But I feel like what happened was this person's spouse got mad. If I can't have you, then no one can. I feel like this person's spouse got mad. I also feel like, yeah, this person's spouse got mad and they pulled the trigger. They killed them. And I feel like it happened, like, either the argument is started in the bedroom, or maybe this is a sign that, like, they stay in the same household, or something like that. But I feel like the person only killed that person because they was jealous of them, or they was jealous of their other connections. Like, instead of this person saying, like, okay, I don't want to be with you, like, I'm going to just walk away from you and just leave you alone, this person decided to kill the other person. And I feel like all of the evidence still I rise is giving me Jesus energy. Okay, this person was probably the person that passed away, probably was really was real powerful. Like, they was real powerful, and they probably was in tune with their spirituality, okay? Which it makes sense, because still I rise, okay? Still I rise, okay? This person wants you to know, like, don't worry about the situation. Like, because the truth is going to come out about who killed them. The truth is going to come out about the community. Like, are all the people that was involved in killing this person? Maybe this person was associated with this community because they probably all sold drugs together. I don't know. Yeah. I feel like this person community went against them. And I feel like this was like either like the community, like the person that they killed was like somebody that was like actually helping people. Now, I'm not gonna say that they was just the angel or whatever, but I feel like they were one of the main ones who was helping everybody eat or whatever. They was like a real essential piece to whatever the gang was or whatever the community, the organization, whatever the group was, okay? But I feel like this person's coming through because they like, okay, you killed me, but I still rise, because this person understood spirituality and this person was ready to go anyway. So y'all really just sped up the process for them. But I feel like, this person is coming through because, yeah, everybody about to get busted. And I feel like everybody already know they about to get busted. That's why everybody is on the run, okay? Yeah, everybody on the run. Like, I'm hearing, like, these people, or the person that did it, the person that originally set the thing up, I feel like they either been setting this person up for like the past 5 years, or for like the past like 5 months, or it could be like five individuals involved. Yeah, it's like the main people are five people, but I feel like it's more than five people because they said it's a community. But I feel like everybody gonna end up going on the run because the truth about to come out about this person, Dev. Like, this person, even though this person is dead, like, this person is coming through. Like, I'm gonna get justice. Like, I still arise. Like, even though I'm gone, like, still I rise, okay? This person, like, y'all thought that y'all was gonna get the insurance money and live a luxury life, but they like, nah, bruh, it ain't going down like that. Because I feel like the person that set up everything, the person probably promised all these people some money, and it's like, you know, what's a lot of money to somebody else, it may not be a lot of money to you. And I feel like that's coming out, because I feel like each person who was involved in the community that, like, the person hired to help them to get the job done or to try to do something to somebody else, I feel like they didn't get no more than $5,000. So everybody that put their life on the line, and everybody that put their kid's life on the line for $5,000. I'm hearing, like, I know they say black kosh, but I'm hearing like the black sheep, or I'm hearing like a black cloak. So this person probably been doing like cloaking spells. I'm also getting like with this black, like this person, not the person that died, they probably did do a lot of black magic, but I'm hearing like, ooh, this is some evil shit. Okay. I feel like the person that set everything up, I feel like they put something in their food, or they came up with this, with a game plan. Well, duh, they came up with a game plan, but yeah, I feel like this person was, the person that set the thing up, I feel like they was already poisoning the person before they even set them up to get shot and to get killed. Or I feel like this person, yeah, they either poisoned them, like put some stuff inside their food, or this person probably did magic, like a death spell, to cause this person to die, or to speed up the process. Okay, it happened at night. Okay. And I feel like the only reason why the other person killed the person, because they knew that that person was in love with somebody else. So it's like, with the, if I can't have you, no one can. I feel like it was on some bullshit. Like either they started arguing too much, or maybe it got to a point to where the person probably could have been like, well, hell, if you keep on talking about the bitch, like I'm not fucking with the bitch, but if you keep on talking about the bitch, then I might as well go fuck with her or something like that. Or maybe it got to a point to where the person was like, well, we just need to just let this go and walk away. And maybe the other person was ready to walk away, was willing to walk away, but the other person like nah, if I can't have you, nobody can. So that means like you about to die. And that's what they did. They set the person up and killed them. And they got a whole community to help them. And it's like, what I'm getting is like, it's not no point in you running because you've been watched. Yeah. Yeah. You see these cards? You're being watched. The whole community. Like this person gone, but they still about to receive justice. They grounded. This person's underground, 6 feet under, but they still gonna get justice. And I feel like this is another sign too, that like the person that set the whole thing up, they do a lot of black magic. They do a lot of chaos manifest. Yeah. They do a lot of black magic. They do a lot of chaos magic. They do it. They do a lot of dark magic. They work with a lot of dark entities. But I feel like with this manifestation card, I feel like, yeah, you achieve killing this person, but this person still about to win. Because your spell work, all that spell work that you did, is about to backfire. And I honestly feel like the person only did it so they can appear to be this. You know? It was. But I get it though, you know? People do reach their points. Like, people do get to their points. I get it. I feel like this was a heavy soul tie. I feel like this was a deep one. And it's about to be so crazy because you see this? Now the kid's about to lose both of their parents. Yep. Yep. Y'all probably been seeing 444 or 666 or 777 or 333. Yeah. And I don't know, the person that set everything up, they could be a stripper, or the people that helped them get the job done could be a stripper. It could be like a gang of strippers. See, she naked. Or this could be somebody that, like, they just love money so much, or that, and they'll be willing to, you know, have sex with a man for money. And then what's crazy about this too is that this female killed this man, but she was juggling him too. So what was she upset about? It's two men in this picture. Like, what was she upset about? If you doing your thing, what you gonna kill this man for? If you was doing your thing too. And I feel like his friends, yeah, his friends helped set the shit up. And this is the truth. What'd that say? Secrets revealed. This is the truth. And this is another sign. This woman and this camel, I know she's sitting down. I know the camel is not no bad energy, but it's like what I'm getting from this is the chariot card, okay? Even though she ain't on that camel, I'm still getting the chariot card. This person, yeah, this person, you see that 36? This person done moved at least like 6 times since the death happened. 36, 26, 42, 6, 6, 6. 666 may be significant. Yeah, the season's about to change. The season's about to change. The season has changed. It's freaking fall. It's damn near, it feel like fucking winter. The season's about to change. The table's about to turn. All masks about to fall off. And it's like, yeah, like, whatever you did on the internet, that's why the cleanup card came out. Whatever you did on the internet, whatever phone call, whatever meeting site, like, I feel like wherever y'all meet in sight at, or wherever these people meet in sight at, they don't even know, like, it's an undercover cop in the meetup site. They don't know that their phone is tapped. They don't know that, you know, their systems are tapped. They don't even know. It's like another thing that I'm getting, take out the trash. They don't even know. This person don't even know that one of the neighbors, this how this person gonna get caught. One of the neighbors seen everything. And I feel like this person is on the run and they trying to clean up their tracks. But it's too late because everything is already on file. Everything is on file. It's like they've been building the case. Yeah. They've been building the case. They've been building the case. Like, they have more than enough evidence to... The police has more than enough evidence to pretty much, like, prosecute everybody that's involved. And look, what I say, this person is on the run. And I also feel like, too, whoever did it, double confirmation, whoever did it was cheating, too. Whoever did it was cheating too. And not only was they cheating, but they was cheating with the same sex. Both of them got titties. Not saying that men can't have titties, but you catch my drift. These two men right here and these two women. This the type of person, I feel like they probably had like a poly, like y'all probably had a poly relationship, you know? Or maybe like y'all used to be the type of couple that used to go out to the club and go get bitches and bring a bitch home on some shit like that. Yeah. I don't need to pull no more cards. This person's on the run with the kids. This person probably got two kids. That set everything up. And look at this number. Another fucking six. I'm done with this reading. Let me get y'all some mojo cards. That was so deep how that song. That was the first song on the list. Person, yeah, this another sign. They want y'all to go to the water. Another six. Maybe somebody probably dumped the body in the water. I don't know. I'm really not getting that, but I just got that message. But they want y'all to go to the water. They gonna meet you at the water. Whoever this ancestor is, they gonna meet you at the water. Like a waterfall. Or just the ocean, period. I'm hearing the ocean. Because this is, you know what? The ocean chose you. 144. Moana. Y'all remember on Moana? When she was a baby? Remember when she was a baby and the ocean did like the little wave, the tidal wave over her head. And she had like the little curl on top. And and that was like the universe like telling her like, hey, like you're chosen one. Like I feel like you're coming into the sense, or you're coming into the knowledge that you are a chosen being. And I feel like that's why the respect card came out, because it's like people have no choice but to respect you because you speak the truth, like you are the truth. Okay, that's what I'm getting. But this right here is another six though. They want y'all to go to the water. I also feel like too, like you gonna get some of this person, the person that passed away. You gonna get some of their gifts. All right, you have the universal light, and you've probably been saying 888. This is gonna help to assist with meditation, concentration, and wisdom. The benefits of the balance, right and left sides of the brain, improves concentration and brain function. Stimulates the pituitary and pineal glands, reduces headaches, and calms the spirit. Opens one to unified consciousness. The affirmation is, I awaken to the divine union of all in the universe. Okay? So your next card right here is fluidity. I feel like they're telling you to just go with the flow, like let go. This person. This person gonna touch you. I'm sorry for that long pause. This person be with you all the time. You gonna know who this ancestor is. Yeah, they gonna be a new guide in your life. Like they gonna be one of your guardian angels. But they telling you to go with the flow. Yeah. They want you to pray tonight too. They want you to pray. They want you to meditate. You're going to see them in your meditation. They're going to come to you while you're meditating. They're going to come to you while you sleep too. They be in the bed with you like while you sleep. They watch over you while you sleep. They're protecting you from these people. This is, oh yes, this makes sense. It's going to help to assist with inner refreshment, emotional ease, and nourishment. They coming through to tell you to relax. Relax. Like, it's okay. Like, relax. Like, you good. You good. I also feel like they're telling you to work on your sacral chakra as well, so you can release the soul tie. Yeah, so you can release your soul ties. Yep. The benefits, it helps to release muscular contractions, supports joints, and eases inflammation, cultivates emotional fluidity and calmness. I'm getting two things. I feel like either you pregnant, you've been having contractions. No, I'm getting three things. Either you pregnant and you've been having contractions. I don't know why I'm hearing like castor oil or something. I don't know. Something about some castor oil. And I'm also getting two, I'm hearing lubricate. Fuck, you know it's late. Lubricate. Okay. But something about lubricating like your joints or something. So they're telling you to like find like some type of herb or something to help lubricate your joints. Like, you know how you gotta put like some WD-40 on a dough or something that like squeak or whatever. I feel like your bones been cracking a little bit lately. They want you to start stretching more and to start taking the necessary vitamins and herbs to not allow your body to like stiff up. I'm hearing arthritis as well. This is gonna have the affirmation is gentle ways of ease flow through my mind and body. Next one right here is this assimilation. I feel like this coming out because they're gonna hold your hand through your journey. This is gonna have to assist with spiritual discipline, transformation, and willpower. The benefits helps to optimize digestion and assimilation of nutrients, supports the kidneys and adrenal glands, cultivates determination and commitment to releasing self-limiting beliefs. They want you to let go. I feel like once you go to that ocean, I feel like, you know what, or like once all these people get locked up, you're gonna be like, you know what, you're gonna finally like just set yourself free. Like, you see how they holding on so tight? They like just let go. Like, you holding on so tight to the past. They want you to let go, release yourself. Okay, it's probably, you probably been constipated. It's probably why you've been constipated, because you gotta just let the situation go and just go with the flow. I assimilate all of life's events with ease and grace. Commitment. Okay. You probably saying 999 and 918. This is going to help to assist with digestion, determination, and focus. Benefits helps to enhance digestion and support spinal alignment, cultivates concentration and spiritual commitment. The affirmation is, I align awareness, focus, and commitment. Commit yourself to your goals. They want you to stay focused on your goals. You got a lot of distractions around you. They don't want this death to be a distraction because they are with you. I also feel like, too, this is another sign that you need to get you a plant. This is going to have to assist with self-healing, balance, and focus. I'm also hearing the aloe vera. So somebody probably got burnt or probably got like a rash or something like that. All you got to do is just get you some aloe vera. I don't know why I'm hearing a lemon or something. So you may need to add like some lemons. I'm saying somebody like add like some lemon to like a chicken or some fish. Or you can add a lemon to your tea. But for your rash, get you some aloe plant, and get you either like some cocoa butter or some aquaphor. Or y'all can use diaper rash cream too. Like, diaper rash cream is really good for like rashes and stuff, and it works really fast. It works, yeah. Or you can get some aquaphor. The affirmation is, I align with nature and receive balance, focus on all levels. This right here is the spiritual truth. I feel like this reading is the spiritual truth about the situation. And like I said, you see how like they hands like this. So it's like this person been leaving like little droplets of evidence everywhere, and the police just been picking them on up, okay? This is going to have to assist with integration, illumination, and vision. The benefits helps to balance all systems and energy centers of the body, supports full yogic breathing, enhances sense of well-being. The affirmation is, I awaken the vision of my highest truth. Your last win is right here. I feel like this is saying like slow and steady wins the race. There go your six again. Slow and steady wins the race. This is going to have to assist with grounding, stability, alignment. The benefits, it helps to reduce stress and blood pressure, assists in proper spinal alignment, helps to reduce anxiety, creates physical body connection. The affirmation is, I cultivate steadiness, comfort, and ease in my body. They just want you to be comfortable, okay? Like, yeah. And go take a shit. Maybe that's why they told you to take some castor oil. Like, I used to be mad when my mom used to make us take it, but it did. You know, you can take the castor oil as a laxative as well. So you might be taking a laxative. I don't know. Hearing too, like this, I'm clearing up for pile number three. I'm also hearing too, like somebody probably could, like somebody that's involved, they could like work it like at a hospice or like a hospital or something. Or I feel like this person was like trying to tell you this when they was in the hospice, or maybe like before they like transition all the way over or whatever, before they transition over. And I feel like you probably was like trying to figure out like, okay, was that person that came to me like before they die, or like right when they die, and they want you to know like that was them. Just fucking my shit up. Fucking it up. Alright. So next, pile number three. Y'all, look at. Shedding a little bit. It still smells good though. I'ma tuck it on the side. I'ma throw it back in there. Alright, y'all. So your last pile number three. Here you go. I'm hearing my way or the highway. Are they live? I feel like this gonna be a love reading. I feel like this person, like, I feel like you a bitch, but this person love that shit. Yeah. She walk like a boss, she talk like a boss. Yeah. They like the way you look. They like the way you dress. They like the way you carry yourself. That's the kind of girl I need. She got a lot of things. That's why I love her. This independent. I feel like this person probably gonna express they stuff like to you during Sagittarius season, or you may be dealing with a Sagittarius. I feel like you could be a boss. I feel like you got a lot of phony people around you too, honey. Phony. Two on the clock. You got phony people around you. You got phony people around you. They tell you you meditate. They gonna show you everybody that's phony around you. Burdock. You got age difference. You got kiss my ass. You got differences. You got overheard. Drink more water. You got suicide. You got let go. You got tricking off. You got Laffy Taffy. You got envy. You got misuse of power. You got all I want is you. Alfalfa. Foolish. Earth. He don't want you. Running. Boy, please, whatever, in the truck. So maybe a man in the truck, like, I don't know. Maybe a man in the shirt, I don't want you. I don't even shuffle these. Y'all, it's hard shuffling these cards. I don't know why. Just play this song back to back. If I was your man, baby, you never worry about what I do. I'd be coming home back to you every night, doing you right. This is what your future person is saying. Your future person is saying, like, let me love you, goddamn it. Okay, so let me love you gonna be y'all son. That's your personal message to you. That's your personal message, okay? That's your personal message, okay? I feel like somebody being foolish because I feel like somebody probably based a decision or based an opinion about you off of something that, like, they overheard from somebody else, okay? I feel like it's killing this person inside, or something that you eating is killing you from the inside out, so they want you to drink more water. I feel like when you and this person, I feel like y'all probably got, like, an age difference. And I feel like once this person finally, like, wake up to who you are, or once this person like, or like once this person see that you serious, like either this person waiting on you to get serious or you waiting on this person to get serious. But I feel like once y'all do get y'all stuff balanced and leveled out, I feel like it's gonna be beautiful. Like, I feel like it's gonna be beautiful. I also feel like too, it's coming out, they saying this song because I feel like this person is probably already in a relationship or they dealing with somebody. But it's like, I feel like this person, I feel like this person know like all the stuff that the old person did. And they looking at you like, I'm trying to offer you like this cup of love. Like, why you still entertaining this person? Yeah, why you not walking away from the person that keep on cheating on you, that keep on doing you wrong, that keep on tricking off with other tricks? Like the person that's controlling, that misuse their power. Like, I feel like that's what the person is saying. I feel like you probably lost some weight too from like stressing out about this situation. I feel like too, like the person that like you dealing with, like you probably even like the wrong person. Like, I feel like this person probably had you so fucked up to where you probably started to have suicide thoughts, or maybe like you tried to kill yourself before but it didn't happen. Okay, something is significant about a truck. So like either you or this other person got a truck or whatever. And you got the boy please, whatever. I don't know. Then you got the running. So somebody running. We don't know. We don't see. I can't get jiggy with this playlist. This is most definitely a love reading because the next thing that's on the list is a healing love energy meditation. So they want you to, your ancestors want you to heal your love energy, to heal your heart chakra as well. They telling you to expect unexpected change. I don't know who idea it was. Oh, this is so cute. Y'all, this person love y'all. You turn this person on. They haven't told y'all that yet, but you turn this person on and they in love with you. Okay. They want to love you. Okay. Look, love you. They want to love you. They want you to like open up your eyes. Turn the lights on. Like, what future said, I'm looking forward with a flashlight. It's not funny, but this person really want to be with you though. And I feel like it's going to be like a genuine like soulmate connection, okay? But then it's like you got the he don't want you card. So either like this person really like don't want you, or maybe this person was attracted to you before and then they're not attracted to you no more. Or maybe this person probably over somebody probably put it inside their ear like bruh, like she don't like you, or he don't like you, or he don't want you, or she don't want you. When the reality side about it, it was just like, yeah, they friends. Yeah, I feel like this person probably listen, like if this person probably like start acting like funny towards you, or start acting like distance towards you, like it's because they friends put some stuff in their ear. Then right here you got the acceptance card. Yeah, like I feel like their friends probably tried to kick it like, oh, like you didn't like them no more, or you didn't care for them, and it was just like you probably didn't even know that like this person was into you, or you didn't even know that this person liked you because they never expressed it because they kept on trying to. It's another thing too, because they kept on friend zoning you, or they was treating you like a friend. Like they, like I feel like this person never came out and said like, hey, I want to be with you, like, hey, I want to start this new thing with you, like, or hey, I want to try to work towards us. I don't feel like this person was like that direct, so it was kind of hard for you to even, you know what I'm saying, like know if this person was like serious or not, or it was just hard for you to know like that this person, you didn't even know that this person wanted you. Yeah, like y'all might work together. And I feel like when you had this conversation with this person, they gonna be like, I was giving you the warning signs. I was like all of the signs was there that I feel like when y'all had this conversation, this person gonna be like, all of the signs was there that I was trying to pursue you, but you kept on doing .. I feel like the conversation is gonna end up being a positive outcome, because I feel like both of y'all gonna, yeah, did this right here, it says the greater knowledge. I feel like both of y'all are gonna have a better understanding about each other and about the situation, and I feel like y'all gonna start off as friends, and then eventually like it's gonna turn into like a marriage or whatever, because you got like the divine love. Like I also feel like this is coming out too, because it's like the universe is supporting like this connection. I also feel like too the universe is protecting this connection as well. I feel like it's gonna be good, because it's like both of y'all got self-love, so both of y'all not gonna allow each other to fuck each other over or do each other like any type of way or whatever. And I feel like both of y'all, it's gonna be like it's gonna be an equal give and take, because both of y'all on the same page. Like both of y'all got the same morals, and y'all got similar goals, and it's gonna be like a yin and yang type. You're gonna balance this person out. Like say for instance, like if you're a poor communicator, your partner is a great communicator. Or like say if you or like say for instance, like is this a joke? Well, that makes sense why it only got 400 views, right? I'm also hearing too, like, timing is everything. So they tell you to take your time. Like, everything gonna flow how it's supposed to flow. Like, make sure you're nurturing yourself. And make sure you're nurturing, yeah. Make sure you're nurturing yourself, and make sure you're nurturing others. This is beautiful. Like, this is the person that wants you, that want to marry you. This is how they view you. Like, they view you like you, like, this, like, super, like, superhuman. Like, you're a great parent. Like, whether you are a mother or a father, like, you're a great parent. You know how to make something out of nothing. You care for other people more than you care for yourself. You in tune with nature. Like I feel like this person is real in tune with nature too. And I also feel like too, like with the baby, like having like the earthy stuff around it, like the water and the grass and the air and stuff, I also feel like too, like this person respects you because they know your worth. Like they know your value, and they understand like the they understand that the female is the creator. Well, I ain't gonna necessarily say like the creator, but they understand that like, yeah, they're the type of person that value So you may be a female, or you may be a male too, because it can go both ways. But they're the type of person like where they understand like the roles of a man and a woman in the spiritual realm and in the physical realm, right? And they understand that like the woman is the manifester in the relationship, and the man is pretty much like the, what they say, we Rockefeller, we behind and we G5. Y'all gonna be a power couple. I feel like y'all gonna have like an umbrella of businesses. You have my heart, and we'll never be worlds apart. Maybe in magazines. Y'all gonna be a power couple. Baby, cause in the dark, you can't see shiny car. Yeah, that's when you need me there. I feel like this person gonna always be with you. Because when the sun shines, we'll shine together. Look, we gonna shine together. Like, this person gonna be equally yoked. Look, this person is saying, like, you remember the first song, the person was like, you should let me love you. Now this person is, like, inviting you to, like, to join them, okay? I feel like you and this person, like, y'all gonna either go out for, like, drinks or tea or coffee or something. And I feel like that's when, like, y'all gonna, like, clear everything out and y'all gonna have a better understanding about each other and y'all connection. And I feel like y'all gonna make a decision on whether or not y'all gonna, like, stay platonic, or if y'all like gonna like start building towards y'all. But I feel like it's gonna be a real healthy relationship regardless if y'all stay platonic or if y'all decide to work towards being in a relationship, because it's, y'all gonna be able to pour into each other. And I feel like, too, with this lady right here, this is another confirmation. Like, this person understands the male and the female role. And they're going to respect you. Like, they're going to treat you like the king. Like, the king or the queen that you are. Okay? I also feel like, too, this person probably going to give you some flowers. Or this person may like flowers or plants. Or this person may be like an herbalist or something like that. Since in between, I love the gun and let the rain pour. I be all you need and more. This person wanna marry you. Y'all gonna be a power couple. You see this? Y'all gonna be a power couple. Like, really powerful. Like this, like, some Jay-Z and Beyonce like type shit. Whatever that is to you, like, on, you know, whatever your level is. But, yeah, I feel like y'all gonna be, like, a real power couple. And y'all gonna balance each other out, like. And I feel like you gonna be able to walk in with whatever you got, you know, your businesses, and then this person gonna be able to walk in with their businesses, and then y'all just gonna combine them, and y'all gonna be able to, you know, like, y'all to be a power couple, you know. It'll be an equal give and take. It's just beautiful, okay? I also feel like, too, like, this person can't wait to, like, get you naked or whatever, but they respect you to where, like, they gonna wait, you know what I'm saying? Like, they gonna wait to do that because they, like, genuinely, like, wanna be with you. Like, they really wanna get to know you a little bit better and, like, see what you're about and all this and that. Like, this, if you wanted to know, like, the person that's coming in, yeah, they a good person. They just want you to stay grounded because you may be a little feisty, honey. Yeah. Oh, this person. Yeah, this person gonna call you or text you. Look at that. This person gonna come forward, and I feel like both of y'all gonna be on the same page. It's just the best way to put it. With this eight, this transformation, I feel like both of y'all gonna change each other's life, because I feel like both of y'all have been hurt in the past, and I feel like both of y'all got like y'all heart closed off. I feel like both of y'all gonna come together and y'all gonna help heal each other. Yeah, this person gonna leave the past behind, and they gonna come in because they tired of being in this energy, and they gonna come in and try to work things out with you. And I feel like this is like another sign that like both of y'all gonna come in with something, you know what I'm saying? Not saying that that's the only reason why y'all gonna be together. Oh, this is so beautiful. Look at that. Look at that. I don't even gotta say nothing. I don't gotta say nothing. I feel like this person be up late at night, like, thinking about you. I also feel like, too, like, this person is, like, manifesting you, praying for you, waiting, being patient. They gonna come through, though. I feel like the judgment with all these cards. This is artist. These are awesome. Beautiful. Beautiful. This is going to be a beautiful connection. Yeah, I feel like this you working. And I feel like this your partner working. I feel like your partner probably got like 7 streams of income, and I feel like you probably got 8. Oh shit, that's lovely. Put that together. This is what's funny. This is funny as fuck. The crazy part about it, I feel like you want this person too. I feel like both of y'all doing the same thing. I feel like both of y'all are not telling each other like how y'all feel. Or I feel like this person probably have, but you like was like, nah, not right now. But I feel like you said, nah, not right now, because you had a lot of shit going on. I don't need to pull it on my cards. Because it's just another sign that like this person is going to cut out all the bullshit, and they're going to try to come back in. I feel like both of y'all going through a spiritual awakening at the same time. I feel like maybe like one person. Again, you should let me know. Maybe it was meant for me to choose this playlist, because it kind of pissed me off a little bit, but maybe it was meant for me to do it, because they keep on playing the same fucking song. But it's funny how they playing the same songs, but it's adding up with what I'm seeing. Yeah. Yeah, I feel like the lady in the middle, I feel like that's the universe, like, bringing both of y'all together. Like, this person might be your twin flame. And I feel like that's what's crazy. I feel like you probably thought, like, in the past, like, you met your twin flame. But I feel like, nah, like, this person, I feel like this person is your twin. So that's beautiful, like, that you'll actually be able, you know what? Yeah, I feel like this person might be your twin, and you don't know it. And I feel like this with this 5 right here, you probably been saying 5, 5, 5. I feel like that's the ultimate change. Yeah, this is a sign. This person about to leave. They. If I bought it, please don't touch. Ain't talking that mess. That's fine. Could you walk and talk at the same time? It's my name, that's on the jack. So clean on your back, let me call you a cat. Standing in the front yard, telling me. talking about how I never ever find a man like you. You got me twisted. Okay, so I feel like this is what this person gonna be telling their ex, or I feel like she sound mad. How about I be nothing, nothing at all to you? Yeah, I feel like. Okay, my phone about to die, so I'm gonna go ahead and finish this up. I feel like this person could be your twin flame, but I feel like, yeah, I feel like this person could be like your twin flame or like your or your soulmate. But you see how you got both of these? This is why I was trying to do this. The lovers, and then you got the two. Yeah. Might be a twin. Might be a twin. Or this might just be a soulmate. Like, a long-term soulmate. It's not going to be temporary. I didn't even know those was in my lap. And that's the running card came out. Well, it didn't come out. It was in my lap. But I feel like that's coming out because I feel like maybe this person was chasing you in the past and they got tired of chasing you, so they stopped. And they ran off, like, with the "I can have another you in a minute." I feel like they ran off. But I feel like they still think about you and still want you. You can feel that energy. I feel like even though, like, you and this person, like, haven't had sex yet. Yeah, I feel like even though y'all didn't have sex yet, like, y'all, that's why I said this person might be your twin flame. Like, y'all are still connected spiritually. I feel like this person look at you like an angel. Yes, I feel like this person already, like, knew who you was. Like, they already seen your potential, like, before you seen it, but you didn't take heed to it. Like, this person may be more spiritually in tune than you, but it's okay though, because this person gonna teach you everything that you need to know. This is a sign. This is your twin flame. Look at them flames. 10-10, you gonna get your twin flame. That's beautiful. I don't need to put it on my card. And look, this is another sign, right? So with assimilation, it's gonna have to assist with spiritual discipline, transformation, and willpower. Your person is manifesting you. They probably not gonna admit it, but, like, if you are already spiritual, like, you know what it feels like when somebody doing spell work on you, whether they trying to call you in or whether they trying to send demons to attack you. Like, you already know. So, yeah, look. I just look like two little bunnies. I feel like y'all gonna end up having, like, two kids together, maybe, like, twins, or maybe this person wanna have two kids with you. Okay, so with the oneness, this is gonna have to assist with spiritual union, balance, and integration. That's what I'm saying. Like, y'all gonna come together. Or I feel like what's happening right now is, like, spirit is bringing y'all together. But I honestly feel like with these flames, this person is manifesting you and they not gonna admit it. But it's like you not gonna mind though, because you want that person too. Yeah, look, this person, that's why they, like, just be still and know them God. I feel like it's gonna work out. Like, it's gonna be a peaceful resolution, and both of y'all gonna be like, okay, cool. And yeah, I feel like y'all gonna be a power couple. Yeah, I feel like y'all gonna have a spiritual business, and y'all gonna have, like, a essential. Well, the spiritual is essential, but I feel like y'all gonna have, like, a spiritual business, and y'all gonna have, like, an essential business. Yes. And the beautiful part about it is that it's unconditional love. Like, it's not conditional love. Like, it's real love. It's unconditional. Like, y'all loving without conditions. All right. And then you also have nourishment. I feel like both of y'all gonna come in and nourish each other and heal each other. I also see y'all too, like, in the kitchen, like, cooking, like, healthy meals, making, like, sauces. Like, y'all probably, like, gonna make, like, a famous sauce or something. Yeah, something like that. I don't know, y'all, but pick a card. Womb Wednesday, we back, we back. Rose forever. Get your girl some roses, okay? Your man, or just get them for yourself, or get them for your child, get them for your mama, get them for your grandma, get them for your auntie, whoever. I'm gonna have the link inside the description box, y'all. And yeah, I'll have the link in the description box. I was about to say something else. Yeah, y'all, we gonna change up some things because, yeah, I think I like to pick a card better, you know. Because, like, sometimes, like, more than one sign could resonate with y'all when I do the signs. I ain't gonna do the signs, but I'm gonna just do something a little different so that y'all don't get bored and so that I don't get bored. And also, too, so y'all don't become so codependent on it and not do the healing work, the shadow work for real. But, okay, y'all, I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Thank y'all for the support. Like, subscribe, and comment. Go follow my hair channel. It's Meaningful Kids Hair Care. And if you want to order some sage, you want to book a reading, the website is shopmeaningfulhands.com. Okay, that's going to be inside the description box too. And we're going to, do I want to close these up? Let me just close it up so y'all can see for the aesthetic. Woo! So you know what? I want to say they have a square box, a rectangle box, and like a heart box, and a round box. Y'all can go look at it. And they got like a little glass or like a little clear case, like where it got like little draws on it, where like the roses is at the top, and then like you can like put like your little, like some little Q-tips or like some floss or something in the box, whatever, something small, something significant, I don't know. But yeah, y'all go check it out. The code is Bella25. It's gonna be inside the description box. And I love y'all. Peace.